Hey folks, Quillotine here, and welcome to Let's Try Sentinels of the Multiverse, the video game. Sentinels of the Multiverse is a tabletop card game where you and a group of friends, your total of 3 to 5 players, team up as superheroes to take down some sort of villain. Unlike other card games, it's not a deck-building card game. Instead, each hero has their own sort of custom little deck of powers that all work in different and interesting ways. And so you're cooperatively trying to take out the villain while also fighting in some sort of environment. Now, this digital version, just like the real-life version, has a bunch of expansions that add extra heroes, extra villains, and so on and so forth. You can get season passes to get a bunch of these as they get released as part of the season pass. So, you know, your final cost may vary depending on exactly how much content you want. There's multiplayer mode. You can quickly connect. You can choose a hero that you specifically want to play and jump in there. There's also these one-shots that they do that run for a week that have a specific villain and a specific set of heroes and try to add a little bit more flavor text to the story. But you can just go new game and create your own adventure over here. So first thing you have to do is you have to choose a villain. Here's the series of villains here. I currently have them sorted by difficulty. So over on the left, you had all the difficulty. Whoops, that's not what I meant to do. The difficulty one villains. There you go. Difficulty one over here. And over on the right hand side, it goes all the way up to the difficulty four villains. So Baron Blade is actually quite interesting. I really like it because he wants to like pull the moon into the earth or something crazy like that. But he's the character that you face in the tutorial. So I'm not going to play him. Instead, I'm going to grab this Ambuscade guy, who's a bounty hunter type character over here. Each one of these villain cards, as well as the heroes, actually have two sides. I don't know if literally all the villains have it, but that's the normal thing, two sides. They come into play on one particular side, so he's going to come in as the superhuman hunter. So he comes into play, superhuman hunter side up. And when he comes into play, he's going to put a certain number of devices into play along with him. So he's got guns and cloaking fields and things like that. Whenever you see this blue H on the villain card, this represents how many heroes he's facing, because you can play 3 to 5 heroes. And in real life, it's great, because each one of your friends, you're playing a superhero. You have to, like, flavor text all your stuff. You can't, like, interact with each other in interesting ways. Playing on your own on the computer is not exactly the same here as you running multiple characters. So H represents how many heroes he's facing. So Ambuscade, I'm just going to pick 3 heroes for this, the minimum. And so he's going to come in with H-1, so 2 device cards into play. And at the end of his turn, he's going to hit the hero with the highest hit points, 2 damage in this case. However, if there's a device that he can play called the cloaking device, it's in his deck, and the cloaking device will just say, flip him over to the invisible stalker side. When he's on this side, he's immune to damage. And then he starts targeting the hero with the lowest HP instead of the highest. So he becomes a real sort of, just sniper assassin type person. Very dangerous. You'll notice there's also the advanced and the challenge setting over here. These are advanced difficulties that you can choose to play in by hitting... No, not that. Oh, right here. Standard, advanced, or challenge. Or ultimate, just for higher difficulty and higher challenges. So we're going to take Ambuscade over here. Then we got the heroes. Likewise, the heroes can be sorted by difficulty / complexity. So Haka over here is an example of a complexity 1. And all the way over on the right, we've got Skyscraper here with complexity of 3. So I'm going to go relatively low complexity here because I'm just, you know, haven't played that much. I'm going to avoid any of the characters that were in the tutorial, if I can remember exactly who they were. I like Parse, so she has difficulty 2. But she's quite cool. I think we're going to set her first because she's got a lot of abilities that affect the other characters. Now, we might want someone tough. Let's throw Bunker in here. Sort of a Iron Man-esque kind of character. Lots of devices and can be quite tanky. I like Knife a lot, but she has a lot of abilities that injures herself. And so if there's not someone who can sort of self-heal or heal other characters, and I don't think either one of these two have it, it might be a little tough to run that. Who do I know so that I'm not just completely lost? I suppose we could play as Haka. What's interesting about Haka, you see how this little symbol here in the top right corner? And you see how the same symbol here is on Ambuscade? That means they are each other's nemeses. So they deal bonus damage to each other. You know what? What the hell? Let's go and run hop. Come on. I'm just trying to drag you. Thank you. Let's run him in here. Finally, we have to choose an environment. Every one of these battles occurs in an environment that has a variety of different challenges and effects. And they likewise do... Well, no, they don't actually run in complexity. That doesn't apply to the environment. And there are all kinds of weird things. The block is an extra-dimensional prison cell. We could be fighting on some sort of dinosaur island. We can be fighting in some sort of industrial complex. I think... What I'm going to want to do for this one is we're just going to play this in Megalopolis, just some big city. I mean, it's going to be, you know, sort of a baseline environment, but I think that's a good one to try. So we're just going to play with three characters. You can always hit randomize here, and, you know, if you don't want to pick. All right, let's go and fight. Boom. So they're going to be taunting each other a little bit over here. I have found you, my prey. Your time runs short. Au revoir. And then Parse will say, I see through you. Your weaknesses are all too visible. All right. So yeah, so I mean, we've got someone with like a lot of weird deck manipulation powers, someone with some devices and can be quite tanky, and we've got someone who's kind of a straight up bruiser type. So we're going to start the game. He's going to put out two devices. He's going to start with his personal cloaking device, which will put him in invisible stalker mode where he can't be targeted, and he will target the person with the least hit points. He's also going to put down reactive plating, which reduces damage dealt to Ambuscade and this card by one. The first time a target deals damage to Ambuscade each turn, this card deals... Okay, so this will reduce damage that he takes, but he can't be targeted right now anyway. And he just played the Vanish card, which I don't even know what it does. Then he's going to use his own ability to target the person with the least hit points. Okay, so we want to avoid getting in a situation where, while he's stealthed, where Haka has the lowest hit points... Or vice versa, when he's not stealth, we don't want him to have the most, because he's going to take more damage. Alright, so, though your turn sequence works thusly. First thing you do is you play a card from your hand. Second thing you do is you activate a power. And third thing you do is you draw a card. If, for some reason, you do not want to play a card or use a power, if you do neither one of those things, you get to draw an extra card. So you draw two cards that turn instead. That's the sequence. However, there are a lot of things that will mess up that sequence and make you be able to play multiple cards or activate multiple powers, that sort of thing. Your character card itself does have a power built in, so you can see here that Parse has the pinpoint shot ability, lets her deal one target, two projectile damage, and combat type or damage type is very important here. So she's actually got a picture of Ambuscade on her card over here, which I think is very funny, but they're not each other's nemesis. Impossible shot. So this would deal three irreducible projectile damage and let her draw another card after it. So she's got a lot of cool utility. That's actually a really good ability. Now that's a one shot. So on my play a card, if I play this, it would just do this and then be over. But there's also ongoing effects over here. So damage dealt by hero targets is irreducible. So this is an ongoing effect. However, at the start of your turn, destroy this card. So really, it's just for one whole round, nothing can reduce hero damage, which is relevant to reactive plating, reducing the damage Ambuscade takes, but not relevant right now. I've got two copies of that, and we've got updated intel. Whenever a villain card enters play, you may lay cut the bottom card of a deck, then either put it on the top or bottom of that deck. All right, that I think it's probably reasonable to play this. Get that ongoing effect going as quickly as possible. Oh, limited means you can only have one copy of this in play. So I'm going to put that down. That's going to be fine. And then for my power, this card does not have a power, so I'm just going to use the one built into my character, which is to deal two damage to something. I guess the thing to do... Irreducible. You know what we're going to do is we're going to target down the personal cloak first. And then I'll make sure to make hero damage I'll make it irreducible so that we can kill this card a little easier. Because right now we do one damage less all the time. By the way, what's going to happen here when I hit this thing? There's going to be a combat animation. You can turn this and quite a few of the other animations off. You can also increase the speed of a lot of the animations if you find them bothersome. And I did, after the first go, turn them off just to play a little bit faster. But I turned them back on for this over here. All right, so... Bunker over here. So we've decided we're going to target the personal cloaking device first. I think that's fine. So Bunker, he's got a few different abilities. So this would be external combustion. This would deal two damage to himself, but deal three damage to all non-hero targets. That wouldn't be very useful right now because of the damage reduction and the fact that Ambuscade can't be hurt right now. We've got Flat Cannon over here, which gives, it's another power ability. So it's equipment, It's sort of the same as ongoing. It stays in play, but this keyword is important. It's limited. I can only have one copy of this. It gives me a power, which lets me deal one target, 3 projectile damage. Seems like a good idea to throw that in. There's also upgrade mode. This is really interesting. This is one of Bunker's things. He's got these modes he can enter. When this card enters play, so all the mode cards say this, when this card enters play, destroy all other modes. You can only be in one mode. And this ability is, you may play an additional card during your play phase. You cannot use powers. At the start of your turn, you may destroy this card. So this lets you dump a bunch of stuff from your hand very quickly. I don't really feel like I'm necessarily in that stage right now. Yeah, I'm not really seeing that. Oh yeah, and Gatling Gun I skipped over. This is really interesting. So at the start of your turn, it deals 2 damage to something. It's not a power, it just deals 2 damage automatically without using one of your powers. But you have to discard a card to keep this in play. I think I'm just going to play the Flat Cannon. Then I get to choose a power. Now I could use Bunker's ability to just draw an extra card, or I could use the Flat Cannon's ability to just deal damage. And I think it's going to be fine for me to just deal damage. So we're going to try to burn down the Personal Cloaking Device as quickly as possible. Probably we won't kill it this round, so he'll deal damage to the person with the lowest hit points, which is going to be Parse, I believe. Got a second copy of Upgrade Mode. And maybe we'll put the Gatling Gun into play. It'll be something good to discard. So Haka's ability is deal 2 damage, straight up. Same thing as Parse, but this is melee instead of projectile. What do we got here? Dominion. Whenever an environment card is destroyed, you may draw a card. So we're going to see environment cards soon. This isn't relevant right now. Enduring Intercession, ongoing. Redirect any damage that would be dealt to a hero target by an environment card to Haka, and it can destroy itself. So he can soak damage from the environment. That might be something. Haka of Shielding. Draw 2 card, then discard 1 or more cards. Reduce the next damage dealt to Haka by 2 for each card discarded this way. So it's a one-shot ability that just has some sort of effect over here. Let me tank things. I don't think that's relevant right now. Rampage. Haka deals each non-hero target 5 melee damage, and each hero target 2 melee damage. I don't think there's enough to be worthwhile right now. So it's probably... I mean, I could put down the Enduring Intercession, or I could pre-put down Dominion. Why don't I go ahead and put this down? So he'll tank environment damage. He can pair that with a Haka of Shielding to soak a ton of damage. So I'm just going to put that down, and for my power, I will just use his own ability to crush the Personal Cloaking Device a little bit. All right, I drew another Haka Shielding. All right, fair enough. All right, so now the environment. Targeting innocents. Oh, the cops are doing dumb things. So this is an environment card that's now in play. Well, we'll talk about it in a second. First, my enemy is going to get a move, Snatch and Grab. He deals the hero target with the highest HP, 1 melee damage. Then either... Oh, and then updated intel. Okay, so because the villain just put a card into play, Parse's updated intel just triggered. So I get to look at the bottom of a deck, then put it either in the top or the bottom of that deck. I'm going to look at Haka's deck. Actually, I kind of want to change my mind. It's a little late now. Well, technically you can rewind things. Haka deals up to 2 targets, 3 melee damage each. I think that's super relevant. We're going to put that on top of the deck. No, I just realized I should have looked at the environment card. Okay, so he's snatching and grabbing Haka a whole bunch, which is not great, because Haka takes bonus damage. Okay, so what the hell just went on? What did you just play? Snatch and Grab is deals the hero target with the highest HP 1 melee damage and 2 energy damage. Oh, that's really annoying. So he did the melee, and then he did the energy, both times to Haka, but Haka's his nemesis, so it did plus 1 damage to each one of those. So it dealt 5 damage instead of 3. Ugh, that is really unpleasant. Okay. Alright, what's Targeting Arrow? Parse deals 1 target, 1 irreducible projectile damage. Increase damage dealt to that target by 1 until the start of your turn. Now, it'd be nice if we could also play this with Reveal the Flaws. because I don't care about killing the personal cloaking device that much. I want to get rid of reactive plating probably first, or pair it up in some fashion. And I suppose we could wait. Hang on a sec. What do you have? You've got the flat cannon, right. You've got the Gatling, which doesn't help that much. Although the irreducible, No, because then we could do damage to this, and then you could do damage to a bunch of things. All right, we're going to reveal the flaws. Hero damage is irreducible. So Parse will use her power to deal damage to reactive plating, which would normally reduce the damage by two, or by one, but it's now irreducible. So we'll do that. And yeah, we'll do a bunch of AoE. Okay, another critical multiplier. So bunker. So this is a great time to do external combustion. So he's going to deal damage to himself. It's irreducible. Okay, select the first target to be dealt damage. The first thing that's going to be dealt damage is the personal cloaking device, which is going to destroy it. Oh, it doesn't flip him back over right away. Ah, crap. He only is going to flip back up when it's his turn. Okay, because I was hoping to killing the cloaking device would flip him back over, but it doesn't. So I'll just say choose for me. It doesn't matter the order. Yeah, so it's worth noting that even though the damage is irreducible because of reveal the flaws, he is still immune to all damage. That's not the same as like reduce damage by one or something like that. So we'll use a flat cannon now, since it's reducible, to do more damage to reactive plating. Although targeting innocence is also going to deal crap down to damage. It's actually going to deal crap down to damage to Haka. An ammo drop. Ooh, whenever, what is that, an enemy equipment card is destroyed? That would be really handy. I think we might want a Haka of shielding right now. Or not Rampage, it's a bad time for that. I think I'm still okay with directing the damage to him, although he's starting to take a fair bit more damage. I'm going to Haka of shielding. Oh yes, draw two cards, then discard. I forgot about that. I'll discard the other Haka of shielding. What is Haka of battle? Oh yeah, it's the same thing. Draw cards, discard, increase the next damage dealt by Haka, one for each. That could make for a massive rampage, and there's actually an achievement to get for that. Well, that's a great power. That's actually huge. All right, I'm going to get rid of Dominion. There we go. All right, stop. So it'll reduce next damage by four, which is going to be... is that going to work the way that I want? No, probably not. It's probably going to be three separate sources of damage from targeting innocence, which means the Haka is not going to work out at all. Ah, crap. Oh, well. Anyway, at least we'll be able to destroy the reactive plating. I did not think about that. That's probably not going to work the way that I want. Haka regain. Oh, I just drew that. That's very handy. So yeah, targeting innocence is going to go. So yeah, it'll take minus four, but the problem is, yeah, that's it. So now, I mean, you'll target there, which will redirect to Haka. But he doesn't have the damage reduction anymore, because... So I burned a card for nothing. Police backup's in play. Oh, I like police backup. This one actually shoots the villain with the most hit points for 1 point of damage. Although he was still cloaked. He's going to uncloak now. Stimpatch, regain three. Shuffles his deck, and then puts another card into play. Yeah, so what I want to do is I want to keep looking at the Megalopolis thing. And hero cards cannot be played. At the start of the environment turn, each player may discard one card each to destroy this card. So this comes into play at the during the environment turn, which means the entire next turn, no one can play a card. No, we'll leave that at the bottom of the deck. So we know what's there now. Oh, apparently you can't go over max HP. That's interesting. Explosive launcher. At the end of his turn, deals each hero target 3 damage. So we know what's at the bottom of Megalopolis. We want to leave it there. Let's look at his deck. What's there? Vanish. Search the villain trash and villain deck for the personal cloaking device. Put into play. Do we care about it coming back? I mean, we got to deal damage to him at some point. No, yeah, we're going to leave Vanish at the bottom of the deck as well. Although he's got mechanics to reshuffle things. So he's going to deal... doesn't matter the order here. Oh, this is going to hurt a lot. I think we're going to get beaten up here, guys. The Nemesis ability. He's done a ton of damage to Haka. Alright, revealed flaws went away. Right, whenever you discard a card from hand, select a hero target. Increase the next damage dealt by that target by 1. So we want this out as early as possible. And then do things that'll cause us to discard cards. We can do another reveal of the flaws, but that's not helpful right now. Feels like we gotta kill the explosive launcher, though. Although, he will be... As long as there's any damage that gets applied to this, you've got Rampage. It doesn't pair together, though. Need to... So this is gonna deal 5 damage to each non-hero. Can you do a variety of damage? What is this one? Ammo drop was... Whenever a villain card is destroyed, you may draw a card, even if a mode card says you can't. Let's say, ammo drop and Gatling gun start going together really well. I guess Bunker will have to play ammo drop, then flat cannon. Yeah, I guess that'll work out okay. So, I don't have any discard mechanics in play right now, but... We're going to go ahead and do that. I mean, I could have targeted arrow, but that ability would have also been wasted. Oh, there we go. I can just... I forgot she's got a power. So she's going to pinpoint shot the explosive launcher. Bring it down to 4. Yeah. Okay. So you've got your flat cannon. I think you're going to put down the ammo drop, because that's about to go away, and then you'll get to start drawing some cards. So you're in fact going to flat cannon the boss. Or, no, targeting innocence. Yes, because then it's going to get destroyed. External combustion, a lot of fun. Alright, so we're going to rampage. Order doesn't matter for this. Boom, take 5. Nemesis, take 6. Rampage, kill this, which will cause Bunker to draw a card. Excellent. Omni Cannon sounds like fun. I don't know what it does, but it sounds good. We're going to limit targeting innocence. And we didn't have the think draw cards from killing environment cards. Too bad. Then everyone on my side will take 2 damage. But that's the way it goes. Do I want to get rid of this thing? 19 HP. I still potentially have ways to regain health and things. No, that's going to be fine. We don't have to get rid of that. We're just going to deal 2 damage to this bastard. I mean, 3 damage, because Nemesis. All right. Haka of Restoration. Ooh, heal... Based on how many cards I've discarded. Okay. Well, we got a couple options there. Impending casualty. Start of the environment turn, each hero may destroy one of their ongoing cards for things. Okay, police backup shoots him. Excellent. Okay, at the start of the environment turn, each hero may destroy one of their ongoing cards. Oh, okay, so this is happening now. I guess the card goes down first. All right. This card deals any hero that does not destroy an ongoing card 3 psychic damage. At the end of the environment turn, one player may discard 1 card to destroy this. Okay, I think we're just going to eat the damage. No. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, Haka. Oh, it's the discard one. Hold on. Is that what I wanted then? Yeah, we're going to get rid of the Haka Restoration, because Vitality Surge heals two and draws a card. So we're going to get rid of Haka Restoration. Okay, I was misinterpreting what was going on. So it never went off at all, because it was the start of the turn, we would take a shit ton of damage. So as long as someone discards at the end, it's fine. Deals the hero target with the highest HP. Okay, so you've looked at that, He hasn't reshuffled. I guess Parsh should look at her own deck. What's at the bottom? Buffer Overflow. When a villain card would enter play, you may discard it instead and destroy this card. When this card is destroyed, draw a card and play the top card of the villain deck. So every time the villain is about to do something, I get to choose if he, instead of has that, plays something else. That probably sounds like a good one to have up there. Okay, we can't hit Haka because he'll take a bunch of bonus damage from Snatch and Grab, so it's going to have to be a Bunker. Bunker will only take 3 instead of 5. Now he's going to target the thing with the most hit points, so it's still going to hit Haka, but overall we took one less hit point than we would have, assuming my math is vaguely correct. Okay, reveal the phones. Right, the Irreducible, that doesn't matter. Right, discard a card to... That's amazing. Discard a card to destroy an ongoing or environment card. I don't need it right now, but what a good card. I guess I could just wait. Should I just targeting hero the boss? I think that makes the most amount of sense. I mean, it's just going to result in a 3 damage attack, honestly. Unless I had ways... Well, I suppose if I play a card that does damage from my hand and then play an ongoing thing, like a power... Yeah, I don't need this now. Yeah. Oh, actually, we'll do slightly more than I was saying. Because I will get to hit him with my power as well. This is really good if you've got anything that hits more than once, right? It hits for 1 damage and then hits for 2 damage or something like that. Because I think it'll proc the plus 1 damage both times. So targeting arrow will do the plus 1 damage. Boop. Alright, there's our Buffer Overflow card, we knew it was coming. So, we don't need to combust. Okay, what's the Omni Cannon? Equipment limited. At the start of your turn, you may put up to 3 cards from your hand beneath this card. Power. Destroy all cards beneath this card. It deals 1 target X energy damage, where X is 2 times the number of cards destroyed. Okay, that does start to be a lot of damage. I'm going to throw down upgrade mode. I can't use powers while this is going on. Never mind. Oh, Gatling Gun is what I want, because it does free damage at the start of my turn, which is great. So now I'll activate the Flak Cannon. It'll do 4 damage because of the targeting arrow. And at the start of the next turn, I'm going to have to discard for the Gatling Gun, but I think I'm just going to discard these upgrade cards. Adhesive Foam Grenade is pretty good to make sure there's no environment cards that come in, but... So Gatling Gun, I need to discard something. Oh yeah, I'll just get rid of the upgrade mode. I've got 2 of them anyway. Okay. Let's see here. What are our hit points? We're at 16, which means I won't be targeted by his ability. If I were to heal, I would be targeted by his ability and therefore take an extra point of damage. This does 2 damage, which isn't helpful. I suppose I'll Haka of Battle. And I want to discard at least 1. So, oh, not that one. Deals each... Oh, another Rampage. Okay, I think I'm going to discard the Rampage then, even though it's really powerful. Unless I just get rid of the heal card. You know what? Let's just get rid of the heal. Because I need to make sure I do at least 1 damage. That way. Because, I mean, it's not very efficient. Oh, right, that just adds plus 1. I could have just done it for nothing. Okay, well, whatever. I thought it was doing damage itself. It's, so, I mean, the thing is, it's that ability is really good if you're pairing it with something that does huge amounts of splash. But I don't want to pair it with a Rampage, because I would do more damage to my teammates. It does work really good with Tayaha, whatever that is, but I don't have any targets for it right now. Impending casualty. Okay, so this is going to be, we have to discard again. Oh, targeting arrow worked with that too. That's really good. So someone's got to discard a card. I think I'm going to discard the Hawk of Battle. I think that's fine. Okay, we got rid of that, so no problems. Okay, things are going really well. Is it half health? Armed and dangerous. He's going to find advice. We get to updated intel. I'll look at Haka's mirror. Haka deals one target, two melee damage, and draws a card. You know what? That's good. Let's put that on the top of your deck. Personal cloaking device came back in. So now we'll look at bunkers. It's a power that lets him regen 2 hit points. I'm going to leave that at the bottom of the deck for now. There's a mode that you can use to let him use multiple powers, and then it becomes quite good, but we haven't found it yet. I don't think anything's... you know what? I'm just kidding. I think just shuffle his deck. Sonic Mine. When this card is destroyed, this card deals each hero 2 damage. Targets dealt damage this way cannot deal damage until the start of the next villain's turn. Okay, so if you're going to kill this, we're going to want to kill this with the last character to act, with Haka. He's also the one who's most likely to kill it accidentally with an AoE. You know what? I think we're going to put this on the top of the deck. I don't think it's as dangerous as some of his other stuff. Who has the lowest HP? We're going to say Bunker, because that way he won't take bonus damage. Automated turret hits the person with the highest HP. Okay. So now we have a tough decision to make. What do we target? Do we kill the automated turret so we don't take as much damage? Do we kill the personal cloaking device so that we can go and start doing damage to him again? I think we're going to have to focus on the automated turret, because I think effectively he's got too many hit points. This thing's going to do... I mean, it's only going to hit one thing for 2 damage every turn. Irreducible damage or thing does not let me avoid the immune to damage. That is different. It's not reducing damage. Oh yeah, buffer overflow. Well, let's get that in now. So buffer overflow, you get to just pick and choose whether you allow a certain card in. See, yeah, we're going to take care of the automated turret. It's fine. And deal damage automatically to the turret with the Gatling gun. I think we're going to throw down the adhesive foam grenade so that there's not another environment card. Well, the police backup's only going to hit someone who's immune, so that's kind of crummy. We're going to flat cannon. Hold on. You have a rampage, which will kill the turret. So we actually are going to hit the personal cloaking device instead. Commission hardware. Select an equipment card from your trash and put it into play. Well, that's handy. I have to trash something so that I can keep the the Gatling gun in play. I'll just get rid of the upgrade mode. I don't think I need it. I'm not drawing that many cards. Okay. We are going to... We're going to use this. It'll deal 3 damage, but then we can still use our power to smash it. Yeah. Or, I'm wrong, I thought that was a one-shot. Shit. Well, now it's in play, which is going to be really good, but it means we don't get to kill it this turn. I done goofed. Thought it was a one-shot. It's better than a one-shot, probably. But it means the automated turret's going to do 2 damage to us. Well, that's the way it goes. And we get the mirror. And that's also an equipment card. Foam grenade, no bad thing. This is going to try to hit ambuscade, but do no damage. But that's okay. We have no environment to worry about, which is nice. You're going to damage the person who's got the least, because you're in stealth mode. No, don't discard Sonic Mine. We are going to get to look at Ambuscade's deck. Charge attacks. increased damage dealt by Ambuscade by 1. Whenever a device is destroyed, Ambuscade deals each target 2 energy damage. Leave that at the bottom of the deck, please. Oh, it's interesting. It's not Ambuscade himself doing the damage with that turret, so it didn't do the Nemesis damage. Okay, that's good to know. None of these are ongoing cards. They're just device cards, so that doesn't get to kill anything. Reveal the Fault doesn't make much sense here. I think this is a perfectly fine time for us to put down Critical Multiplier, because there's actually not a whole lot of useful targets. I'll get rid of Automated Turret now. Ammo Drop allows Bunker to draw a card. External Combustion. Maybe now. Although, all it'll do will kill both these devices. In a way that's not necessarily handy. Because this will deal damage to each... Yeah, we don't really want to kill it with anyone other than Haka, because then Haka won't be able to do any damage. So just do that. Yeah, we get an equipment card from here. None of these are equipment cards. Alright, I'll just put down the Omni Cannon. It'll give us some interesting options. So Haka's turn, he's just going to go ahead and use this ability to whack both things. Or he could just use the mirror to just kill the personal cloaking device and then draw a card, which is probably handier. In any case, Bunker's just going to draw a card. Grenade Launcher. That sounds like fun. And he's got another copy of Ammo Drop. Not that it's helpful. You know what, then? He's going to discard it to keep the Gatling Gun in play. All right. So you're going to play Mirror. Then as your power, you're going to activate Mirror, dealing damage to the cloaking device, which will kill it, and drawing himself a card. All right. I gotta say, Bunker's drawing a crap ton of stuff as a result of killing the equipment here, the devices. Paparazzi in the scene. Heroes cannot use powers. At the start of the environment turn, each player may discard one card. Oh my god, so we can't use any powers? Reactive plating. Is it possible he'll put down something more dangerous than reactive plating? Reactive plating's a pain in the ass. Yeah, discard it. Run and gun. He deals the hero target with the highest HP 2 damage, shuffles the villain trash into the main deck. Okay. I don't remember... I think Haka, we need to look at you. Punish the weak. Whenever Haka would damage the non-hero target with the lowest HP, increase the damage by 1. Whenever Haka would deal any other target, reduce that damage by 1. I don't think that's useful. Just leave it at the bottom for now. Alright, you reshuffled your deck. So, we will take a look at what's your deck now. Problem is, all his cards are dangerous. I don't know, leave that down there. If you found another Sonic Mine, maybe. Like... Vanish. Oh my god, you're gonna get your cloaking device again. Whatever, we don't have to look any depth. How many things are you doing on your turn? Jesus Christ. You're just permanently cloaked here. Alright, this is starting to be kind of a little damaging here. Look up how Beabat Parse looks. Poor guy. So, I can't use any powers. And unfortunately, I can't use Segmentation Fault to get rid of it, because it's actually a power to do that. So... I think we targeting arrow the personal cloaking device. You can rampage to do a shit ton of damage to it.
and kill the custom hand cannons. Yeah, I think that's going to be okay. We got to make sure that this is down to 6 by the time Haka is going to go. There we go. It's going to be down to 5 now. No. So grenade launcher is deal 1 target 2 projectile damage, may deal a second target 2 projectile damage, may deal a third target 1. That's a lot of splash. Still, I think I'm going to throw down maintenance unit. I won't be able to use it right away, but it'll give us some options for power going forward. You can trash one of these external combustions. Alright, so we're going to rampage. Well, order doesn't actually matter, I don't think. No, I don't think so. I mean, in a sense, killing the Sonic Mine means... I think I can only not deal damage to Ambuscade. Cannot deal any damage. Yeah, so it's important the Sonic Mine dies last. Oh, he's drawing a lot of cards there, Haka. Going on to upgrade mode might make a lot of sense. So, we're going to hit that. It'll kill it. It'll deal 2 damage to each hero target. Order doesn't matter. Draw a card. More heavy plating. Damage order also doesn't matter here. The cannot deal damage goes away at the start of the villain's turn, or the end of the villain's turn, one of those things. Mm-hmm. No powers. Draw that. Yes, all players agree to discard a card for the paparazzi. Whenever a non-hero target enters play, increase damage dealt to that target by 1. I like that a lot. I think we're going to get rid of extra sensory awareness. Whenever you discard a card from your hand, select a hero target. Increase the next damage dealt by that target by 1. Haka. You're going to get rid of one of your heavy platings, because you can only use one. I already have one of these in play, don't I? Yes, I do. Good. So we're going to get rid of this one, especially since I want to keep everything else I've got. Plummeting Monorail. At the start of the environment turn, this card deals 2 targets with the highest HP 5 melee damage. Is Ambuscade still going to be cloaked? No, so he might take the monorail damage. Rigged to detonate. When this card enters play, shuffle it face up in the villain deck. Drawing that is really bad. This is not an ongoing effect, it's a hit point thing. This card deals the 2 targets with the highest HP 5 melee damage each. I think we're going to exploit vulnerability, which will make it easier to kill some of his stuff. And then we're just going to deal damage to him. Another critical multiplier. Do that. I mean, we gotta make sure that he's still gonna take the damage. He can do a shit ton of damage with this. You know what? Yes, I do. We don't need the grenade launcher. Recharge mode is what? Destroy all the mothers. You can't play cards or use powers. Draw an additional card during your draw phase. I don't think we're gonna need that. We're getting lots of cards. And decommission hardware we don't need. Now, here's the thing. I kind of want to put down a Disa Foam Grenade to stop an environment card from screwing us, but I'm so low health, I need heavy plating. Now, I'm at 6, 8, 9. So, this card deals the two targets the highest HP, 5 melee. Won't that damage Emasculate and Plummeting Monorail? It will. As long as I keep him above 9. So I guess I could Omni Cannon him right now. Or I could Maintenance Unit myself. So I don't die. Well, I'm not going to die yet. All right. Right, I got to discard. I'll keep it. It might end up killing him, the combustion. Although with the heavy plating, he will take less damage. So, oh, I got to be careful about healing myself. Well, being exactly at 10 is fine. And this gives me 2, right? Yeah. So we're going to Vitality Surge. Be at 10. Draw an extra card. Then I get to use a power. I'm going to bring him down to 13. Or 12. No. Critical Multiplier. That's okay, it'll bring him to 10. So he's going to be tied for all this. That's also fine. Didn't realize I'd be doing so much damage here. Ground Pound. Okay. See, they're all tied, so I get to choose who's got the highest hit points. Well, Ambuscade does. Who's got the second highest? Plummeting Monorail. Order does not matter. Whack. Whack. He's down to 5. I think we've got this. Cramped Quarters, change type of all damage to melee damage. Increase all damage by 1. What? He's going to get shot. He's got the Cramped Quarters as well. So he's down to 3 hit points. I mean, if he cloaks again, I'm going to be kind of annoyed. Reactive Plating is okay. He'll take 1 damage less, and the first time we hit him, he will take 1 damage more. I don't think we need to do that. Or well, he'll reflect 2 damage to my characters, but that's okay, because we can just kill him. In fact, Impossible Shot is irreducible. So it will just guarantee the kill. Alternatively, I could reveal the flaws to make everything irreducible. But, blam! Gets changed to melee, gets plus 1 damage, irreducible. Whoopah! Whew! Yeah, because if that face down card that he shuffled into his deck, or rather he shuffled it face up, had turned up, I think we just lose instantly, I think is his ability. So there we go, here's an example of the amazing Sentinels of the Universe! Again, you know, some of your gameplay may vary. If you do get annoyed by some of the UI stuff, like I kind of did, the automation here is quite handy, and then you can always turn off, like, the page flip, the damage-dealing animations, the animate damage modifiers, those were fine. The new game cutscene, you can choose the animation speed. That's right, I still had it fast. That's why some of the cards seem to go away pretty fast here. But yeah, I don't know. You can pick your poison. Actually, kind of grew on me in that particular game. Maybe I was just really impatient last time. I'm not sure. Sentinels Universe. Thanks for watching. See you next time.